Hey Jessie Bess, happy birthday. I can't believe you're 18. Well, really, I can. It feels like you've been approaching 18 forever. I've loved watching you grow up. It's been such an awesome experience being 10 years older than you and, you know, being like your second mom and then, you know, just growing up with you and then becoming your friend when you got into your teenage years. And I'm so proud of who you have become. You're a beautiful woman. Oh, woman? Weird. Girl. Anyway, I know it's a bit of an interesting time to have a birthday, but that's okay. There's going to be plenty more years to celebrate. And just from everyone in the family, happy birthday, and here they are.
Go.
Come up behind the bathing boxes. I can talk out of the wind. Oh, that's better. It's a little bit quieter here. Just wanted to wish you a happy birthday in this COVID environment. That's crazy. One of the things I just love, the time that I've spent with you and love you so much. And a lot of that time that we've shared together has been on the beach. So that's one of the reasons I'm down here. Whether it's been trips to Noosa, which we've done many every year. And even the highlight for me was when we, with Georgie, you and I went to Broome. And what a great time that was and the colours that came out of that. And some of the terrific photos I have here of you is just sensational. Just us on the beach there at Cable Beach. Here down at Cape Levique. And there's some beautiful shots there. And that's that old Hilux that we rented in Broome to drive up to Cape Levique. And what a great trip that was. And we got you to drive sections on the road there. And it was a manual gear shift and you did really well. Anyway, have a great day. I wish we could have a party together. Unfortunately, it's not going to be the case. Love you so much, Jess. And looking forward to having so much more times shared with you in the future. So happy 18th.
Hello, it's me, Fatty Ratty, otherwise known as Professor Rat, Fat Boy, Fat Rat, or just Ted. Happy birthday, Jess. I wanted to take this opportunity to say how proud of you I am for becoming, for turning into such a serious girl with reliability and sensibleness that cannot be knocked. And a good sense of balance and a really mild sense of humor. But in all seriousness, you're a really kind-hearted person, and yeah, I'm really excited for who you are going to grow up into after this as well. I hope you're having a good day in lockdown. I hope it's a good one. It sucks that you are in lockdown, that we're all here and we can't really be all together. And you can't go out clubbing, go drinking, but that's okay. You had your fake ID anyways.
Happy birthday, Jessie!
Woohoo! 18 today, girl! Well, cheers to that, don't we, chill?
Oh, cheers, yeah. Cheers!
Legally able to drink. So, Jess, not a great time to be having a birthday during the corona times, but I guess it'll be one for the memory books, that's for sure. And I just wanted to say, we put together a little party feast just for you. So thanks for cooking the soso rolls, Jill. I've baked you a little cake just in honour of you, Jess. And just a little something funny. I was looking through some old photos and I was like, oh, little Jessie, she's growing up so fast. 18 this year. Crazy. Anyway, found this gem. Thought you'd appreciate that. You were an absolute cracker growing up. I have the fondest memories of all our babysitting time. I think it was a weekly event. Charlie came along one time.
We even saw the Smurfs. I remember when we took her to the Smurfs.
Oh, we love the Smurfs.
I smurf you. That's my favorite quote. That's something that I remember. But anyway, Jess, love you heaps. Have a great birthday. And just think of the party that we're all going to be having on the other side of this, because boy, will we be ready to party. Yay!
Happy birthday, Jess, for your 18th on Saturday. I'm sorry we can't all gather and have a huge celebration, but hope you get lots of prezzies. And looking forward to gathering and celebrating and more holidays, more ski holidays with proper snow. We didn't get much this year, but next year. And Matthew, you might come?
Yeah, I'll definitely come. Happy birthday, despite the restrictions. Hope you have a good day, and looking forward to seeing you soon.
Happy birthday. Hope you have the most amazing day. This is the worst time ever to have a birthday, we know. But I'm sure everyone will be able to make it very special for you, despite everything that's going on. And we hope the whole year ahead is amazing for you. And oh my God, I look like an idiot. And you're still able to celebrate as much as you can. So have the best day and see you soon.
Hey Jess, I just want to take you through some memories that I found at the farm. So when you were a baby, you were the best birth ever. It was fantastic. And you were also the prettiest baby. That's a view of a bit older, but you were very, very pretty as you grew up. And I just want to show you, here's Momo. Momo and Pippo. But you decided that Ellie was going to be your favorite, and Ellie is there now. This is your little whistler hat that you wore when you went skiing. And then as we go across, you collected a lot of stuff, jewelry, whatever these things were, watches, everything you collected. You also very much got into arts and crafts. Oh, and you did a lot of that, including writing in books that you started but never finished. Girls only, keep out, go away. Knitting Nancy. Oh, look at this little top. So cute. Then, as you got older, you were the star of gymnastics. Absolutely amazing from the age of 3 till about 16 or 17. Look at this little leotard. You won a lot of gymnastics competitions with your friends. Look at your little shorties. Then you got to Brighton Beach. Oh, remember this bag? With all your stuff, here's your Wesley one. You went to Wesley as well and did a whole gymnastics thing. Look at that beautiful leotard. And Brighton Beach. Who can forget good old Brighton Beach days? Driving up in the car from Windsor. And netball. You're so into your whole netball. You still are really good at netball. And you said goodbye to all your friends. You did the Connors run. And you got to St. Michael's. St. Michael's, you went to Cambodia. You made new friends. And you got your teeth done. Changed your life forever because you became a teenager. And we had so much fun going through your years as a teenager. Clothes, bathers. Wasn't this the jacket I got for you in Italy that cost me a lot of money? And now it's scrumpled up at the farm, been worn probably twice, along with other thousands of dollars of clothes that I've purchased for you and that you've purchased for yourself. So now you're about to turn 18, and I can't believe where the time has gone. You have turned into a beautiful, mature young woman, not so concerned about your clothes, but also concerned about things like what you're doing your media on, about relationships and families and coming together and having and making memories. But I know it's in isolation, and you are very sad that is part of what your year 12 experience is, but it will get better, I promise. I want to show you our little song that we used to sing as we went to school every single day. As you can remember, we loved Miss Morris. And so here it is, the last 10 seconds of do 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 do.
Missy Morris, Miss Morris, ugly baby Morris, Miss Morris, ugly ugly Morris, Miss Morris, scratchy veggie Morris.
So I'm going to take you back now to the time around about this, when you were about grade 4, grade 5, and suddenly what we had become, we had been very close as we had been, as you were growing up, and we were very much one-on-one, we used to sleep in each other's beds and all that type of thing, but somebody new came into my life, and I'd like to introduce you to him now.
So then along came Chris, and you weren't too happy about him to start with. So I'll let Chris tell the story.
Hello, Jessica Rabbit. Happy 18. So I now believe I've known you for half of your life. I think I met you when you were 9. And first encounter was in the little igloo in the play area outside Bendigo Street, where you got me in the igloo and you interrogated me about my past and who my ex-wife was and things like that. Very confronting. But in the 9 years or 10 years that I've known you, we've been to 6 countries. We had an interesting trip to America to meet up with Mum and Tara. We hardly spoke the whole way to America. You found it a bit weird. And then there was the European trip where lots of stories of you puking on trains and crying and all sorts of things, but I think you had a good time. And then all the way through your life, and I think probably the next biggest thing was your bloody 15th birthday party. We had all those yobbos and gate crashers. And I did my shoulder in and I ended up in hospital. But I still like you, and dare I say love you anyhow. So happy 18th, and hope you have a good one. Sorry about the ISO.
Quick, she's coming.
She's almost here. Have we
presents
got everything?
There. Exciting, excellent. Tequila.
Oh, she's here.
Get down. Quickly. All right, and all right, nearly there. 3, 2, 1.
Surprise! Happy 18th birthday, Jess. Can't believe that you're officially an adult now. That's crazy.
We just wanted to wish you a really happy birthday during all this lockdown. Obviously, we can't be there with you.
And we have spent so much time with you over the years. I can't believe we first met you when you were in primary school and now you're 18. So it's so, the years of just, I can't even, they're all just mushed together, but we've had some great times. We're traveling through Europe. I mean, maybe not so much of the vomit from yourself, but it's okay. It's a funny story now. And also traveling to Disneyland and America. We had some really, really fun times there.
And look, we're looking forward to, once this is all over, we should all go out for a drink and just have a nice time.
Hi, Jesse.
Happy birthday, Jessica. I wish I was 18.
I'm sorry we're not going to be with you on your birthday. I hope it's really fun. Make sure you have lots and lots of...
to drink.
Which you will anyway.
Thank you.
See you later.
Hi Jessie, happy birthday. We're so sorry that we couldn't be here with you today. But what we did is we went to a supermarket and we took a big photo of a big huge balloon to celebrate your special day. And a few little tiny balloons to say how much we heart you, love you. So wish that we could be with you, but handing over to Ollie to say his special words.
Well, happy birthday, Jessie. We've known you since you were born, of course, and most times we see you as at a family gathering. Unfortunately, because of distance and other unrelated issues, we can't be all together today. So, happy birthday from us here in Bangkok.
Happy birthday, Jessie.
Happy birthday, Jessie. Sorry we can't be there.
And it doesn't really matter because 18th birthday parties suck. 21st birthday is way better.
That's right, we'll have an extra big bash then.
Yay! Beckett says happy birthday to his favourite cousin auntie.
And he put on his favourite outfit.
He got all dressed up.
What
for
is
you
in here?
You dressed up.
My first memory, I think, of Jesse would have been the Christmas in Kirribilli. We stayed in Manly that year. I reckon Jessie would have only been about 13. So it's going back quite a way. But I think as far as Jessie's best attributes, I think she's very family and orientated, very wholesome. You can tell by the way she plays with Lola, to Chaz and Kirby, and even to Beckett now. I think it's absolutely beautiful how family orientated she is. So.
My favourite thing about Jessie is her Instagram.
Which is lit.
It's fire.
What's your favourite thing?
She's good at
playing with me.
Happy birthday! Hi Jess, I hope you're having a great 18th. Wish we could be with you and have a great night. Get drunk. Love you.
Dad, remember we gotta do the thing for Jessie's 18th.
Oh, yeah, okay, I'll do it. Okay, this is for Jess. I'm really gonna make an effort. I've made a bit of an effort for you, Jess. Eden, give me a hand. You ready?
Yep. Happy birthday, Jess!
Happy birthday, Jess!
Everybody, let's put your hands up for YM team in Cambodia.
What'd you say, Po? Happy birthday, Jess.
Hey, Jessie, happy 18th birthday. Remember this poem that you and Luigi gave me for my christening day a few years ago? Well, I'm going to read it out now. Yay, Joe, today is your christening day. One boy, special boy, little boy, cute boy. You are last from the Elfin clan, but still a very special man. Today we wish you lots of luck and hope you enjoy this red toy truck. Billy, your brother, is kind and dear. He will always be there, so have no fear. Sisters Chloe and Lola too. We play and stay with you. As you grow and grow and grow, you will constantly know that everyone in this, your clan, love you dearly, my little man. Happiness throughout your life. We wish you well and a pretty wife. Love from Jessica and Lidge. And it says love from Jessica and Lidge down the bottom here too. And there's a bunch of stars here. Thanks for this and happy birthday, Jessie.
Happy 18th birthday, Jessie. There's our little banner for you. Yay. Although it's back to front. Oh well. Happy birthday. My favourite memories of you is a comparison of when you were a little, funny little, scraggly haired kid. Gorgeous little snow white blonde girl with knotted, matted hair, and now you have the most beautiful, long, silky, knot-free hair. I wish I had that. I'm trying, but it's not quite the same. And I always remember you were absolutely divine when Jay was just a little baby. You were just besotted with him, and it was always very, very sweet. So a happy day. It's a very, very exciting time to be turning 18, even though it's not ideal in this COVID time. But we all love you very much, and we're thinking of you on this very special day, hoping you are feeling loved and feeling very special. Happy birthday. Bye.
Hi, Jessie. Happy birthday. I reckon my favorite memory of us is in Bali. And there's this photo that comes with it. And I really just remember that day because we were just getting ready for Jordan's wedding and we were having a lot of fun, and the whole trip was a lot of fun as well. It wasn't just that like one day, it was the whole trip that was really fun, all the like shopping and like getting fake tans and just like trying to tan before the fake tan and taking a bunch of photos, being my like personal photographer whenever we see each other. That's always a lot of fun. Yeah, that's just what I just remember most. It's my favourite memory of us out of all the ones we have, and like all the times at the farm and Port Douglas and yada yada. That's probably my favourite one. It's most memorable because Bali was amazing. Anyway, I hope you have a happy birthday. Congratulations on being 18. I'm so proud of you and so proud of everything you've achieved and gone, come over. And yeah, I love you. Have a great day.
Happy birthday, Jesse. I hope you have an awesome day. And make sure you celebrate nice and hard once you can when lockdown finishes. I remember when we were younger, we used to play with your Barbie dolls, and probably a little bit of a guilty confession here, I loved it because for some reason I thought Barbie dolls were awesome. And yeah, that was very fun. Have an awesome day. Bye-bye.
Hello, Fat Rat. Happy birthday. Hope you have a great day. I remember when we were in Port Douglas, it was raining, so we spent the entire day inside with Jasper watching Shane Dawson theories, and we filmed our reactions, and then later on we were doing like a double piggyback, and Jasper's pants split, and he just ran from the room, and we were like, what's going on, what's happened? And he was like, my pants split, I have to go. And that was so funny. And then, and then also when we were in Rye and we spent like hours learning TikTok dances and they were like so good in the end. We were TikTok gods. It was so good. And even when we were younger, when we did that Marry You music, we did that dance routine to the song. That was so good with Chloe and I think maybe Jasper, I don't know. But yeah, so many good memories with you. Happy birthday. Hope you have a good one. And hopefully I can see you soon. Yeah. Bye. Mwah.
Hi, Jesse. Hope you have a very happy birthday. I can say that you are the person who introduced me to Taylor Swift when we were in Thailand. We're going down this really steep road trying to catch a ferry, and we're all jammed into this car, and you were very upset because of the car sickness, and you were worried about that. And so Karen put on your favorite song, which was Romeo and Juliet by Taylor Swift, and we played it full blast, non-stop, all the way down that hill. And so now I can actually sing you Romeo and Juliet by Taylor Swift, but I won't. So anyway, I hope you have a really great birthday, and it's a really exciting time, and all the best. Bye.
Hey, Georgina's, just got back from the cafe. Just wanted to do a shout out to my little sister, 18 today. Happy birthday, Jess. And as always, stay fine as Georgina's.
And now we should sing Happy Birthday. I'm gonna do the first chord, and then we can go from there.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Can you give us one smile? Oh, God, I can't. Okay.
Love you.
Love you.
Why don't you just say something about Jess and then...
Like what?
Like...
Happy birthday?
Yes, and then you can...
Hi, are you starting?
Yes.
I'm not fully over it. It's really bumpy all along.
Love you, Jess. Have a good day.